This module about Python function and scope of variables. Myself Konkan Jana, Assistant Professor of Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. JAS Group, it's a joint venture. So the topics in module 6 are Python function, introduction, categories of functions, built-in function, user-defined function, function definition, calling a function, function with arguments, function with an argument and return type, function with default argument, function with variable and argument, key value pair as variable and argument, pass by reference versus pass by value, scope of variables, local variable, global variables, memory management, stack or runtime, stack, heap. We have learned and completed Python. We have run and completed Python function introduction. Completed Python function introduction. Already we have done it. Next categories of function, we have completed it. And within this built-in function, user-defined function, function definition we have completed. Next, calling a function, function with arguments, function with an argument and return type, function with default argument, function with variable and argument, we have completed. Now, key value pair as variable and argument, pass by reference, pass by value, scope of variables, that is the rest of the topics I will cover in this lecture 4. This is about our lecture 4 and this is module 6. So let's start with the last lecture of Python function. We will do more coding exercise on Python. For coding practice and exercise, I am using Python IDE with Python 3.3 shell, and I am using digital whiteboard for better clarification. Note down the text what I am writing in this digital whiteboard. We have completed all this section. Okay. We have completed this one, this one, this one, this one. Okay. So we will start today this lecture. Key value pair as variable length argument. Now, under certain circumstances, there might be a situation where the key value pair needs to be passed as the variable length argument to the function. Let's first take an example here. In the given example, the key value pairs are passed as variable length
argument.
First we'll start with a coding example. Okay, just I am writing this code. We are using Python IDE. Okay, so I am writing this code within a new file. Okay, suppose I need to define a function first. Okay, I need to define a function. So what we have to do? We have to use the df keyword. Suppose infocity is the name of the function. Okay, infocity is the name of the function. Okay, here I have used the variable var like that way. Pointer to the pointer of the member, pointer to a pointer. That concept will be applied in this section. Now, next, I need to print the variable value. Specifically, this is for the list item. Now, one by one, print all the items of the variable. This is the way by which we can print all the items with index value. With index value, and that means the key value. Okay, now call the variable. Now call the variable. Variable name is infocity. Suppose the name of the variable I have written there, and the argument is like that. Okay, these all are the arguments I have passed to this infocity function. Again, next I have declared this variable and pass all this value like that way. Okay, clear? In that way I have passed all the value of this variable. Okay, infocity name, this all of the variable infocity name, we have pass all this argument here. Now run this code. Now just tell me what you are seeing there. Now compare to the code. First, using a for loop, we print out each key value pair that is passed to the function. On the first call, we pass only few key value pairs, while in the second call to the function, we pass a bit more key value pairs and we get the output as we have seen. like that. Okay. So what we have done there? We have write it down. Okay. This is the first call. Using a for loop, what we have used? We have used the for loop. Okay. In this for loop, each key value pair that is passed to the function. Each key value pair. In that way, we have passed it. In that way, we have passed it. On the first call, we pass only few key value pairs. Okay. This is the first call. This is about the first call that will be called there. Okay. Okay. And these all are the arguments. There are few arguments. Okay. Name, age, city, these all are this. Okay. But for the second call, what we have done? We have called all these arguments. Again, we have used all this pair of arguments. Okay. In that way, we have get this result. Okay. This is the result we have get there. So, this is about the key value pair as variable length argument. The key value pair of variable length argument. Okay. You need to mind that this is variable length argument. Okay. And key value pair means the list of pairs will be implemented there. Key and the value, corresponding key and the value will be printed. So this is about the function call with some arguments and the value will be written corresponding to that. Now pass by reference versus pass by value. Pass by reference is the term used in some programming languages, in C, C++, where values to the argument of the function are passed by reference. They are passed by reference. Passed by reference. Where values of the argument are passed by reference. That is the address of the variable is passed. Passed by reference actually means this is about passed by address also. You can say it, this is address also. Okay. This is about the address also. Okay, you can say it as address also, pass by address. So this is about the pass by address. Now what will be happened? The operation is done on the value stored at this address. Pass by value means that the value is directly passed as the value to the argument of the function. In this case, the operation is done of the value and then the value is stored at the address. Okay. So these two type of difference you can notice in different type of languages like C and C++. In this case, that means in Python, arguments, the values are passed by reference. Okay, values are first by reference. This is by reference. Okay. During the function called the called function uses the value stored at the address passed to it, and any changes to it also affect the source variable. Now I will give another code example. Okay, I will give another code example. Okay, so go for another code. Just I am writing this one. Now suppose the name of the function is passref, and I will pass a list through this function. Passed a list to this function. Now extend this list, and we like to print it. Extend the list and print this list. Okay. Next, in the main code portion, suppose I have the items of the list as like that. Now print the list. Before we made any changes, list before pass. Okay. Now print the list. Okay. This is the list. Simply I have printed it. Next, call the list through the function pass reference. Okay. And print the list outside the function. Here, what you can see, just watch it. What you can see here you can see that, okay, list before pass is this, list inside the function is this, list outside the function is this. Okay, before pass was it, and after pass outside this one that. Okay, so here in the function definition, we pass the list to the pass by a reference, and then we extend the list. What we have done, we have extend the list. Extend means some value will be added to 389. Okay, it was in first condition, after that it will be extended. Here we have done it. Here we have done it. It have extended. Okay. And we have extend the list to add two more numbers to the list and then print its value. The list extends inside the function. But the change is also reflected back in the calling function. We finally get the output by printing out different representations of the list. So this is our code. Before this, we have extend the value with that was the extended value. Okay, that was the extended value. Okay, that was the extended value. Okay, so it is extended for this calling function. Okay, now we get this like that way. Let's look at another scenario. Okay. With code, just I am writing another code. Okay. And explaining what happened there. Okay. This is the function. Function is the function. I have passed this inside the function. Okay. Now, this is ordinary function. Now, what will be happen? Just watch it. Inside the function 14, outside the function 10. Okay. Inside the function 14, outside the function that is 10. Okay. The preceding example might make you think it is called Y value, as the change happening inside the Python function does not get reflected back in the calling function. The calling function. It is still a pass by reference, as in this situation inside the function we made new assignment that is A equals to this. Okay, we have made the assignment as because we have used the assignment operator. Okay, that why it happened. Okay. Otherwise, it will be in reference of the variable. Although you might think that A equals to A is a changing in the number stored in A, but it is actually rearranging a 2 point to a new value. Okay, so this is about the pass by reference. Okay, now next, this could be an entry unique topic for you to understand for the first time, but it is actually a very simple topic. Let's try to understand this with a real life situation. This is scope of variables. Okay, type of situation. You might be aware of two types of airlines, domestic and international carriers. The scope of domestic carriers will be restricted to a particular country's operation only, while an international carrier has the scope to operate on an international border. Same is the case with variables. The scope of the border aspect define the access level for specific variable. There are two basic operation, international and local. Okay, within the country and global, within the world. In like this, in this language Python also you have two basic scope of variables in Python. Okay. This is the scope of the variable. Scope of the variable. Okay. One is local. Local variable. That means it is bounded to this portion only. Bounded to this portion. And this is global variable. So you have the access to all this area. This is global variable. Okay. This is global variable. Okay, so what I have told you, I have told about the scope of variable. Okay, one is local and next one is global. Next one is global. Okay. So, a variable is defined inside the Python function. Local variables are only accessible within their local scope. Within their local scope. Already I have given you as an example. Okay, local scope. That will be accessible within the local scope. Okay. I can say this is the local scope. Suppose this is the local scope. You have mentioned this is the local scope. Okay, list one have this visibility. Okay, but k is the global variable. K is the global variable. Okay. So local variables are only accessible within their local scope. A global variable is defined outside the Python function. And global variable, where you have defined this? This is outside the Python function. You have defined it outside the Python function. Outside the function. Globally it have declared. Okay. Global variable are only accessible throughout the program. Here the variable k with value 4 is an example of a global variable. Okay, already have told you k is the global variable. Okay, while the list one variable is an example of local variable. This is the list one. List one is the local variable. Okay, this is the local variable. Okay, this is the local, list one is the local variable. Okay, so global variable is this, a local variable is this. Okay, now the area marked in green inside the main function shows the scope of the list one variable, while the area marked in yellow shows the scope within the marked with the source within the add function, and this scope is valid until the end of the add function. The succeeding example will explain both these types of variable. Okay, just I am giving an example of the local and global variable, how they will be accessed. Okay, so this is the this is our function inside the function variable. Now run this one. Okay, inside the function the value of a is this local variable a, and outside the function the value of a is acting as global variable. How they will access there? Okay, function a equals 12, a equals 10, you have access this one. Okay, so in that way you can access the variable a is a global variable. Its value remains the same outside the function compared to the value inside the function, where it is acting as a local variable. Okay, so but so we have learn more about the local and global variable, but if our time permit, then we will discuss in details later. Now just I am giving the function memory management. This is quite a fascinating topic and is also a big pain for any programmer who has to deal with memory related issues such as memory leakage issues. However, since it is a big topic which needs to cover at the intermediate stage, we'll try to explain the very basics of the topic. In the earlier days, memory management used to be handled manually by the programmers who could better understand manually memory management than C and C++ language programmers. In new concept, there have no concept of memory management because we have enough memory. So programmer have to worry less in these sections. So local scope of the function contains parameter and variable. The complete local scope must be stored somewhere in the RAM of the computer. We know that. Okay. In any programming language, stack or runtime stack and heap, these two type of memory management is present. Memory management, one is stack and another one is heap. Okay, If these two type of memory management scheme, okay, is into two parts in a programming language. Now, this heap is a specific area of RAM where all values are stored. Okay. Values are stored in the heap. Okay, this is the heap. Values are stored in this heap. Okay. So this is about the very basic of memory management. Okay, and we have completed module 6 in Python. Thank you.